Okay, so this is our first interview for Contemporary Leadership, and we decided that we're going to go paint a room at Manly Hospital. So what do we need to do firstly?
I think we need to go approach the hospital and make sure that we're actually allowed to do it, like they might have some restrictions or something.
And like, so we have to see like what room they'll give us, like how much paint we need, and like when we can even do it as well.
How are we going to be paint?
Maybe we can go to Bunnings, I know where I saw a sign there. And they have lots of paint.
What
are the signs? It said contemporary leadership students.
Are you sure?
Well,
so
we
should go just to Bunnings and Manly and then just approach them and tell them about our project. Maybe we'll have to write a letter or something.
A lot of businesses are usually pretty lenient about that.
I'll write a letter if you like.
Yeah, we can, and we could go around different businesses in Manly and see if they want to donate as well, if just in case Bunnings doesn't like donate.
Yeah,
just in case they need a big room or something. But firstly, we're going to go to the hospital and see.
It's not too big.
Yeah. Hopefully, we get a small
room. Hopefully, yeah, like a kitchen room, not like a
kind of really good kitchen. It's a 2-tiered room with a metal wall feature.
Alright, so let's. How about we just go to the hospital now and then see what.
Okay, Bunnings ring them all. I've donated to us.
Doing the first paint job on the wall. Woohoo!
I thought this is
our progress on day one.
So it's the end of day one, and
it's gonna take a lot longer than we thought it was.
We're only halfway through the undercoat.
Not even halfway. But we'll feel good when we get it done.
This is the first wall that we've painted. This is our top coat.
I feel like our rags are just too painted now.
So this is our final meeting, so we finally finished painting after 20 odd hours. So what are we going to do today?
Pick up the check for the blinds.
Yeah,
and
we're going to go look for them.
Look for the blinds.
Install them.
So that's our final part of the project. We're going to put blinds on the room we just painted because they're an ugly green colour.
And then we're going to put this video together.
Yay! As we only have 30 seconds to talk about what we learned from our Contemporary Leadership Project, we're going to divide up into sections to see how our project was successful. So to start off with, we went to approach the hospital and communicate with them what room we could paint and when we could do that. After we contacted the main nurse, she contacted us to tell us that Leonie Sadler, who is from the Cardiac Rehabilitation Ward, would let us take paint her room.
So we're trying to find sponsors. We went to one business first and they seemed pretty keen, but they never even told management about it. But then we went to a different Bunnings later and they were more than happy to help, and they provided everything we needed and even more than that. We got rollers and paint and brushes and absolutely everything we needed to paint, and it was really simple.
The one of the most challenging parts of the project was the actual painting itself. We had to find schedules that fitted in within our study and the hospital's caring procedures. It was good to liaise with everyone and make sure everyone pitched in. And we also learned a lot of important stuff about painting, so brush strokes and technique.
Yeah, there were some communication barriers which we had to overcome, such as getting letters from the dean to give to certain people and letters that we wrote to businesses. Such as the one we wrote to Bunnings, we needed it to be passed on to management. The one from the dean, it was quite hard to chase up for about insurance, and another one to verify that we're like a charity doing community service for a real estate agent who were giving us money. So this is a bit of an unexpected
Barrier?
Barrier? Obstacle. Obstacle that we overcame.
About servant leadership is that it takes a lot of hard work and you to be willing to gain a sense of community spirit to work towards hard. And it's good with what we did because what we were able to do was help the staff and the patients at Manly Hospital have a better facility by painting the room, and we hope that it also encourages them to have a better sense of community as well.
Okay, I'm Leanne Sadler, a clinical nurse consultant for cardiac rehabilitation at Manly Hospital. Five students from the International College of Management approached Manly Hospital a few weeks ago to paint a room as part of their community project. The site manager, Helen Eccles, then approached me because it had to be an area where where it didn't interrupt the patients at all. Okay, and so it was decided that the cardiac rehabilitation, a room in the cardiac rehabilitation room would be painted. The girls were very, very helpful. They actually went, contacted me a couple of times, worked very well with me. Then managed, came in and moved all the furniture and painted, put the first coat, undercoat and the first coat on in 2 days. And we were able then to continue with the patients on the following week. And then 2 weeks later they returned and put the final coat on the room. It looks absolutely fantastic. The girls were very helpful, very polite, worked in very well with me, and the guy, I should mention Ben as well. I met the girls and guy, I forget about Ben. And Ben.
This is the clock upon the wall. This is the story of us all. This is the first sound of a newborn child before he starts to crawl. This is the wall that's never won.